Thinking aloud. Conversations on the leading edge of knowledge and discovery with psychologist Jeffrey Mishlove.
Our contribution is that we greatly increase the likelihood that the experiment is going to be successful, in that we're able to help the viewer separate the psychic signal from the mental noise.
Mm-hmm. Which is one of your particular gifts as an interviewer.
No, so it's the interviewer's job to pull out of the viewer what he's experiencing without naming it.
Yeah.
So the source of the mental noise is memory, imagination, and analysis,
mm-hmm.
together with naming and guessing and grasping.
Yeah.
And this, I should say,
all normal mental habits.
All of those things are sources of noise.
Yeah.
For example, when I did an experiment with you.
Yes.
We sat down, and the question is, Elizabeth Rauscher is another physicist, went to hide somewhere. And I said, Jeffrey, here we are. What do you see with regard to Elizabeth?
Mm-hmm.
And you said, it looks to me like Macy's department store. And in my mind, that answer did not sound like remote viewing.
Mm-hmm.
It sounded like naming or guessing.
Yep.
And I rudely said, don't tell me about Macy's. Let's take a break. Tell me what you're actually experiencing.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And you said, well, I see a bunch of wire hangers, one in front of the other, a whole row of wire hangers on some horizontal post.
That's correct.
And that's why I said Macy's.
Yeah.
I said, well, that's a very interesting description. Could you draw that?
Mm-hmm.
And it turned out that Elizabeth was standing at a pedestrian overpass over Bayshore Freeway, and where Hal was standing, if you looked where he was looking, what you saw is a bunch of triangular pieces of wire forming the pedestrian overpass, amazingly like what you had drawn.
Yes, you could have put my drawing right over the photograph. It was practically a perfect match, but I didn't consciously perceive that. I still was imagining a rack of clothing.
That's right. So it's the job of the interviewer, even though I don't know the answer, of course,
yeah,
to help you to separate your desire to guess and to name it. The desire to name the target,
mm-hmm.
is what makes it very, very hard for certain kinds of ESP experiments to work.
Mm-hmm.
For example, in our work now for 20 years, we never see a decline effect. That is to say, Hella Hammond was a New York photographer,
mm-hmm.
who was with us for a decade, and she turned in excellent work for her entire decade. She did not decline.
No decline. Whereas with the forced choice card guessing types of experiments, the decline effect became normal.
That's right.